And Bubba Kush. Yeah, we can talk, she rather fuss. This and that about such and such. Man, damn, where is the fucking trust? I'm tired of the hoop and hollering. I'm about to take the coupe to Collins. Then take a female to the island. Then take her clothes off and do the honors. Yeah. Now she hear I'm with them other bitches. Yeah, I told her mind her fucking business. Shit, she probably out your fucking niggas. I'm fucking her friends, now her friends ain't even fucking with her. Damn, she text me all day and night. So pissed off, she ain't even spelling shit right. I text her back and tell her it's life. Now somebody tell them hoes I'm single for the night.
I am 21 years old.
My age, I'm 21 years old.
47.
I am 61.
I'm 17 years old.
I'm here to discuss the topic on sexism and hip hop.
My views on sexism in the hip hop culture is that it is degrading to females.
I do not like hip hop. I don't think it's nothing positive coming out of it.
The way I see it, I'm a hip-hop artist myself, an aspiring rapper myself, so my views of sexism and hip-hop, it exists, and we see it all the time. Yes, women are exploited in music all the time, predominantly African-American women, and those of other minorities such as, you know, Hispanic, and things of that nature.
Sexism.
They can be kind of bad because of the things that they say in music, like make it rain, like they telling girls to go out and make it rain and take their clothes off for cash, and that's not good. Instead, they should be telling them to become doctors and lawyers.
Getting to the point, they view them as basically blending in with the population. You know, that's what goes on today in today's society. Most, you know, females or female artists or dancers or whatever their profession may be, when it deals with things like that, you know, their family members, they're concerned as well as others, but they just look at it as it's part of life.
It's very degrading to women. I mean, a lot of people might not see it that way, but it really is. It shows too much nudity and just disrespectful.
The way I look at it, sex sales ultimately, so that's a corporate mindset that put that in there. Sexism wasn't originally part of hip-hop. I mean, sex being sexy and having a woman in your videos, I mean, all rappers have done that, from the old school artists to the new school artists. But as far as the overall view and overall perception that they put on television and the media, it's like, it's just what they doing to make money. I mean, it's not a good thing, but it's not a bad thing. It's people get paid off of it, give people jobs, and the economy, it's a recession, and the money is all messed up all throughout the United States, so people gonna do what they gotta do to make their money, and these corporations not finna go broke like some of these other companies just because people don't like what they showing, the images they showing on TV.
BT exploits women a lot, you know, no clothes. I think that's just plain ugly.
They need to have better clothes for these females. And females degrading themselves too.
Take for instance that TV show Glee. That's a high school TV show. It's a lot of hip hop and stuff in there. But you don't see the profanity. You don't hear the profanity. You don't see the barely their outfits and stuff like that, you know. That's a positive TV show.
My personal views, I don't agree with it because, you know, it's not necessarily the best image to feed to the younger girls, but I don't disagree with it because it got to be done. It's part of life. I mean, it ain't as bad as pornography. It ain't, they don't boycott the strip clubs. It's right down the street from your high schools and your daycare centers. So it's like, I mean, why bash the rappers for having some sexy half-naked women in their videos? Just being real.
With the women that actually can wear, like, regular clothes, maybe a t-shirt and jeans, just, you know, the usual.
What about casual wear?
That can be a good idea also. But, you know, like, as far as just, you know, the females who, you know, like, have all their stuff hanging out, all their everything, you know, it's, like, so unattractive, and it's setting a bad example for others and, you know, the upcoming of the society.
Yeah, I put an age limit on stuff. Because it's all about the maturity level. That's what I think. It's all about the maturity level. Like, young kids and toddlers and stuff, they shouldn't be listening to stuff like that. They gonna be corrupt.
Yo, auntie.
Shut up. Sex sales is what I learned. Also along with that, by showing so much off of your body, you can only go so far with.
You know, really, as bad as some of the stuff on the internet and the TV is, there's not too much that I would say should change for one reason. Because people are going to do what they want to do regardless. Everything you see on TV and on the internet, from pornography to explicit uncut videos to just regular videos with girls in bikinis, these are things that people think about all the time. That's why the media use, that's why these companies use it, because they know that's what people want to see.
Y'all know how to block the internet. Y'all know how to block certain TV stations if you got cable or whatever. Because it ain't gonna come on regular TV like that. Take control of your children.
Women should be more respectful. You don't have to be naked and show your body to the world to be sexy. I would like to see more class. Women put back on their clothes and be a lady. And you can still perform, you can still show your talent to the world. That's what it's all about, not your body.